gon' sip a card and like, it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck. Birthday, you'll find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Look, mommy, I got the ecstasy into taking drugs. I'm in the having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, get into getting rough.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here. We're broadcasting live on EMD live streams. We welcome our guests both here in person and over the internet. We are here for our final competition tonight for EMD Fight Night 4 in association with Cuban Boxing Club and People's Fighters. We need to give one final thanks to our sponsors, Valtrans and Park Onyx. We are now ready to introduce our last fight tonight. Now, this last fight is going to be a 10-round featherweight contest. We're going to see Hazibullah Ahmadi from Afghanistan take on Soleiman Marti from Ghana. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to meet our fighters. Fighting out of the red corner, all the way from Ghana, please make some noise for Soleiman Marti.
My mystery box is somewhere very near. I feel it inside me, I'm feeling very weird. Something where I did chase for years back in the days. If you told me I would see this flag waving, I won't believe you. No, cause how far could I be? Yeah, I'm too close, I can feel it. Something is vibrating inside me, I'm celebrating. But outside they kill me. My own self they kill me. My own anxiety, my inferiority. What? Them all they kill me. Them all they kill me. And I don't feel okay. My heart is beating so fast. So fast. So fast. Oh, soldier, 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 soldier. Stand and beat your chest. Did they come? Did they come? Did they come? No, may them catch you off guard. Don't let them
go. And now let's meet his competitor. Fighting out of the blue corner from Afghanistan. Please make some noise for Hazibullah Ahmadi!
جلال و بشانت قسم با پاکی رود روانت قسم با کوه و با دشت و با دامان تو با مرغ بلند آشیانت قسم که جان و تنم رو فدایت کنم همه هستیم رو با پایت کنم که جان و تنم رو فدایت کنم همه قسم قسم بنام از قسم های وطن 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 بنام از قسم های وطن تاریخ زرین تو با نام آوران زمانت قسم با هرات و بلخ و بدخشان تو با غزنا و هم قندهارت قسم با پیران با علم.
Gentlemen, welcome to the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, this is our final contest of the evening. This is a 10-round featherweight contest. We're going to see Afghanistan take on Ghana. We're looking forward to this one. This is sanctioned by the MEPB. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee is Shahzad Janab. Your judges, Gary Kitanowski, Mike Hale, and Ahmed Saeed. Let's get ready to go boxing.
All right, gentlemen, the main event. So you're both professional, conduct yourselves professionally, make sure you keep the punches clean, fight strong, fight hard, and obey my commands at all times. Good luck to both of you.
We've got the final fight of the night.
Good luck, gentlemen. Let's go boxing.
Marty versus Marty. Afghanistan versus Ghana. 14-0 versus 13-0. It's going to be an interesting fight for sure at the featherweight category. Amadi is walking his opponent down already. He's, you know, he's doing feints, body feints, you know, looking to see what's what. Good defense from Marty though at the moment. He parried a jab. Good signs of good boxing skills. Calculated performance at the moment from both boxers. Not trying to do too much. It's a 10-round bout, so you know they have 9 more rounds of being in the ring, so they're not wanting to, you know, expel too much energy, give too much away.
Good start from both fighters.
Definitely.
They all look
very sharp with the shots here
and composed.
I like how Awadi's using the distance. He's going, he's in range. In Marty's range, he comes straight back out.
I kind of like also what Solomon is doing, keeping his jab and trying to keep away Hasib from inside contact.
Mm.
But also Hasib, you can see he's trying to go close so that he can work on the body.
Good left hook to the body there.
Both fighters have good experience having both of them.
Good straight right there from Amadi. You can see that they're both experienced. You know, you can tell by how round one's gone. Good shots there by Marty, backing him up into the ropes. First time in this round that he's been on the offense and pushed Amadi to be on the back foot.
Good body shot from Hasib. Ten seconds to go to the first round.
Good job there. Good movement from Amadi.
And that was the end of the first round.
West Coast, where you at? Let me get a hand clap. West Coast, where you at? Let me get a hand clap. West Coast, where you at? Let me get a hand clap.
Why's he did it? Why's he did it? Why's he did it?
LA, show me love up in the club. The bank, show me love up in the club. LA, show me love up in the club. The bank, show me love up in the club.
California, 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 in the city of LA.
enter round two. Round two's kicked off to an action-packed start with some good inside work from Marty. And he's keeping that lead hand out to measure his range and distance. That was a good uppercut to this, to Amadi's body.
Good shot from Solomon.
Very, very good. Not too sure why he stopped the combination in that fashion, but you know, each of their own. A bit of footwork there, fancy footwork to entertain the people around at ringside. Looks like he's getting, Martin's getting very comfortable in there, which is good. He's looking like he's having a better round this round. Enjoying it, having fun. Amadi's looking like he doesn't really have too much answers to what's going on in front of him at the moment, which makes sense.
Better you be serious and stay composed, or whatever you're doing.
100%, yeah. He's definitely staying composed. As you can see, he's throwing shots.
Solomon's trying to be cocky.
Taking steps back.
Yeah.
He's letting him just do his thing. And that's what you just, you're meant to do that. You can't get drawn into it. Marty's tried that left uppercut a few times and it's just landed. It just did a triple left hook. He's very confident in his movement. He's confident in himself. You can see the flair he has, the swagger he has. But again, this is a 10-round fight, so this can change the match.
Good job from
good left hook there from Amadi just now. Yeah, very good. Good straight right and a left hook to the body there. But it looks like Marty just shakes it off like it's nothing.
Both guys are so composed, so relaxed. You can tell from the experience they both have.
Yeah.
I kind of like both fighters, whatever they're doing. It's working for both of them.
It's good. Styles make fights, and both of these guys have the styles that make an entertaining fight. Even though much may not be happening, but it's still something that you want to keep your eyes on.
This is not the kind of fight you want to lose your concentration. Exactly. Anything can happen.
Anything can happen, for sure.
You keep frontin', say what you gon' do to me, but I ain't seen no- I'm telling you to loosen up my buttons, baby.
This is how we do. Nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love. This is how we do. We make a move and act a fool while we up in the club. This is how we do. Nobody do it like we do it, so show us some love.
We go to that round.
It's like Marty's coming with a bit more aggression with the front, being on the front foot here, straight off into the third round. Good jab, solid jab. That was good. A bit more power on that. That could have been Marty in trouble there. Solid jabs in round three from Amadi. Very stiff. He's got his shoulder behind it.
Good head movement from
good shot selection there from Marty. That was brilliant. I think that was four shots off the lead hand. If think that overhand right went to Marty's chest, but it could have been issues if it did land up top. Marty's got good shot selection, but he's just not planting his feet as much as Amadi.
He's losing, you can tell he's losing balance from the back foot.
So yeah, exactly. So he's not really generating that much power to phase Amadi, as you can see. If he did, then he wouldn't keep coming forward. But Amadi stayed composed, even after, you know, Marty was doing his his little tricks in the ring. That was good left uppercut. We've seen how successful that was against the Gamboa fight.
Yeah, Gamboa utilized all those uppercut, double uppercut.
He did,
and
indeed.
Hooked, and they worked very well for him. Good head movement from Hasib, and good. Kind of working for him whenever he moves his head, he's going to the body shot and hook.
He's throwing good good single shots, and when he's ready to throw his shots, he throws some good combinations as well. He just threw a left-right hook there. That was a hook, left hook to the body, left uppercut. He's on the inside to work, but he's tightening up, keeping his elbows tight, just as he should. Marty again just being a bit off balance and getting too close.
Good job from Hasib using his range and his jab.
Beautiful work from Habib. I just got sweat all over my
yeah.
my face. I feel like I'm fighting. But you know, luckily I'm a fighter, so I'm used to this. It's good work there from Amadi. Brilliant work. Inside work as he's making his opponent miss. He's throwing shots, keeping the range perfect.
And that was the end of the bad run.
Yo, they wanna know. I want you, can't tell me. I keep it sexy, daddy, so I can't fail. Keep it gangster for the coward, so I give them hell. Call me misfit, lips for the gang of trash. Riskless now, cause I made a gang of cash. Like glam, still street with the durag. Slang, spit, gang, change speech, how they do that? Watch they mouths drop, watch the crowds pop up and act out. Brawls with the screw face, smash on the knockout. Ain't change, ain't on me, I run the game. If I gotta keep it green, so be it, I'm so insane.
We're into the fourth round now of this 10-round fight in the featherweight division. Looks like Amadi's coming to put under pressure again, as he has been throughout this fight. I think he lost it in the round two, but he's been very effective with it. He's been very effective with it in the third and fourth round. Good shots here from both, good jabs from either. Good footwork from both of them as well, to be honest. But running in like that, that's how you can get countered.
Whenever you're moving forward.
Exactly, he's running.
With that pace.
Putting his feet in front, should be in a stance, but you know, it could work for him.
Good uppercut from both fighters, yeah.
From either.
Solomon have to stay serious on this. Because I see a bit strong, very solid punches.
Good overhand right there. Brilliant overhand right. Marty's just shaking it off. But you don't want to be getting caught with too many of those shots. Good left hook and control inside work. He's working off the lead hook. There's a lot of lead hook shots right there. He's working that left arm like he could have injured his right.
Look for a right hand, man.
Yeah, I hope he hasn't injured his right. It's too early for that. That was a brilliant right uppercut straight through the guard. And as you can see, Amari just working, teeing off on the body, coming up the middle. It's beautiful work and combination at the moment.
Very good job from both fighters. Hatib now working on the Amari. Solomon working on the defensive end.
He's really whipping them left hooks into the body, man. He's whipping in the shots. And that's what you're meant to do. When you're ready to throw your shots, you plant your feet, you bend down, let it come from your legs, and he's doing the exact that. Good shot
good
there.
Good hook from Hatib.
And Marty, sometimes he just leaves his hands a bit too low. Coming in and out of the clinch, that makes him get caught with shots like that.
I need Solomon Konaman, they need to tell him to control his all uppercut because
sure.
All of them, they're not connecting. No. He's throwing some wild uppercuts.
Yeah, exactly.
He need to make use of them. If he need to keep controlling
perfect right hand at the end.
Yeah.
Dropped it in nicely. It's looking like the tide of the fight's kind of turning, to be fair. It looks like Amadi's getting his momentum and he's working him, he's breaking him down slowly but surely. He's getting very successful in his last few rounds. He's been very successful. Marty, he doesn't look like he has the
Solomon. Grit. Solomon did a good round from that was a good round for Solomon, though. He needs to avoid using those wild uppercuts so that they can keep use of them.
He just needs to plant his feet a bit more to gain a bit more power. It could be causing problems. But at the moment, it looks like Amadi is really being switched on in all rounds and taking it to him.
Good stuff from Hatib.
It's good work there. You see,
he's just
slowly backing him up onto the ropes, into the corner. Not necessarily throwing a lot of shots to back him up, but he's just doing that calculated pressure with his feet. As you can see, he's backing him up, and look, he's back in the corner again, just by the movement. Amadi, he's fighting a smart fight, a very smart fight. You see the intelligence here. He's walking him down to rope to rope, corner to corner. Good movement there as well.
Nice footwork. You can see the kind of ring craft.
Marty probably needs to angle off and get the center of the ring a bit. Gain the center of the ring. Right now he looks like he's on the defense, but he doesn't look like he's throwing any effective shots. Like how the previous fight,
Faizan, Messi.
That's the one. He was the previous fight. That's how he was in the defense, and he's throwing perfect shots.
I mean, Solomon need to get serious on this round. When he started the fight, was much better than whatever he's doing right now. But kinda his hooks are all connecting. But you can see he's not putting too much pressure on Hatib.
Yeah. That's good. He's keeping his range. He's not getting too close. Look, he's letting him throw shots. He's coming out of range, making him miss. It's a beautiful display of boxing right now. But I do believe Marty has the power too.
He has the power, but he's not connecting his power.
He's throwing shots and he's going into the opposite stance. That was a good body shot. He's looking like he's probably got a bit of fatigue in his fourth round. Good shot there. Left uppercut, straight right from Amadi. Look, I feel like he's got times of he loses concentration and drops his guard. And that
can be so wrong because anything can happen. If Hatib can jump on any right hand, it can lead to even a knockdown.
Exactly that.
He needs to keep his hands all the way, even if he's tired. He need, whenever he's moving, he needs to keep his hands up.
That's when the discipline needs to come in, you know? He's getting a bit too reckless and wild with what he's doing.
Yeah.
He's throwing wild shots, jumping out of position, out of stance, and he's getting caught with these shots. Because Amadi, he's staying in stance and he's, you know, throwing his shots in balance.
He has good timing, but all he needs to do, he needs to plan on his punches.
Yes.
100%. And his combination, because he's throwing some wild punches which are not connected. And you can see from Hasib, all Hasib is doing is being composed, relaxed, and watching him from a distance.
Yeah.
All Solomon needs to do, he needs to keep the same pressure he's using, but stop using these wild punches because they're not doing anything. And exactly. He's getting tired whenever he throws them.
But he's trying to put so much into that punch as well. Mainly it's the left hook he's trying to throw and he's missing.
Yeah.
As we know as fighters, when you throw big shots and you miss, it takes a lot out of you. Just like if you were to land, it wouldn't take that much out of you, but when you're missing like that, it's going to burn you out, and you can tell that he's already fatigued. Amadi and his corner's already going to see that, and they're going to formulate a game plan to capitalize on that as well. So be interesting, fifth round.
Let's see what's going to happen on the sixth round. If Amadi can keep the same pace, we can see some good round at the end. I don't think Solomon is tired as if the way he was showing at the end of the fifth round. Let's hope he gets some good advice from the corner.
Yes. It just looks like Marty doesn't look as switched on as Amadi. But he does still have the combinations and the
good overhand the from movement
to cause him issues.
Good overhand right again.
Yeah, perfect. Good uppercut there from Marty though. He's backing up into the corner, but when he throws him shot,
they're connecting.
He throws shots and he's leaving his guard wide open. But with Amadi, when he throws his shot, his guard is still tight.
See,
you know?
And his back leg is all straight, as if he doesn't have balance from the back foot.
Exactly. It doesn't look like he's generating enough power. And clearly he's not, because Amadi's still there to fight. But even, good shot. But
Amadi have realized that his overhead hand, the guy is open on his left hand. Again, same thing.
Yes, I think he's noticed this now. Ooh, good shot there. And he's hurt, Amadi. On a good left hook. He's been throwing it for a while, trying to land it, and he's landed it and he's hurting, but he's gonna give it, if he gives him time to recover, this could be an issue, but he keeps throwing and going off balance. He can get caught with a shot himself. These shots are landing, but it doesn't look like he's phasing, but Marty's body language is quite concerning. It doesn't look like somebody who wants to be in this ring right now.
He's not someone who was ready for this fight, and he knew very well what he's coming to.
Exactly, it's a 10-round fight. It doesn't really look like even signs of his movement, him going back into the corner himself. Good jabs to the body.
You
that
can
that takes the air.
As if he realized he's tired, he's going to walk from up going down, going up.
Yes. Overhand right, probably going to come from there. Good uppercut there on the right hand, and another one.
Solomon is, you can see, he's tired.
Yes, he's holding up. But look, even this, arms down, he's going square. He's not in stance.
But this is not the kind of fight when you're fighting 10 rounds you need to do. If you're tired, you need to move around the ring.
Get your breath
keep your
back.
Hands up. Yeah.
Yeah, get your breath back, get your breathing right. Well, this is what the corner should be saying, but I'm not too sure if he's listening to the corner.
You cannot afford to show your opponent that you're tired.
He needs to show discipline at this stage, you know?
A fighter fighting for 10 rounds is not a... It's a high-ranked fighter.
Exactly. And if we can notice he's tired, then Amadi can definitely tell that.
And you can see Amadi is trying to destroy him with all end of the 7th, 6th round. I mean, the corner man and the
and the judges, they're supposed to tell him what he's supposed to do. Solomon is not using his time to capitalize on his power punches, because each and every time you see, whenever he tries to use any power punch, he's losing balance on both feet.
All the time. But again, this is boxing, and you did see Amadi get, he's winning the fight, but you did see him get hurt in that last round.
We go to the seventh round. This fight is scheduled for 10 rounds.
Straight in there.
The moment the bell rings, Hasibi is ready to work.
Straight away. And again, that's another sign that he doesn't look like he really wants to be here. I could be wrong, I hope I am. But as a boxer, you don't see these type of this activity unless you don't want to be in there. Good shots there.
Good uppercut from
but again, that left hook is way too wild.
Too much wild.
Yeah.
And he's been using those kind of punches since he started. He need to realize that they're not connecting. He need to change the kind of punches that he's using.
He does, but he did land one, and that did damage him.
It destroyed Hasib.
But he needs to switch up the tactic on how to land it. Set it up with a feint, set it up with a jab. You know, do work on the inside, and then throw it.
Another problem he has is keeping his hand all the time down.
Yeah.
Which can be a very big mistake.
Again, there's a lot of discipline that needs to be shown in this fight right now.
Good shot from us
here.
Whenever you're using your ring craft, you're supposed to keep your hands up.
All the time.
This is what Solomon is not doing.
You meant to defend yourself at all times.
Yeah.
And he defends himself when he feels like he's out of range. But a lot of times he's been caught. Even now, he's throwing shots and he's got his guard back up good. But when he throws shots, you need to keep your guard at your chin, your overhand, your opposite hand at all times. Good uppercut. Very good
uppercut. And that one hurt him.
Could have wobbled him. Definitely could have affected him there. Good set up there. Unfortunate attempt. Marty needs to get out of this corner. He doesn't need to be there. Marty's teeing off on him.
Martin looked gassed out.
He looks tired, he does indeed. It.
And that was the end of the seventh round.
Round, you see Amadi still applying the pressure, backing him off into the corners from early in the round. Good shot selections, keeping his range as well. He's not smothering, and if he does get too close, he starts throwing them overhand as well. Marty attempting to feint and do a few out of the book tricks, but it's not really landed. That was a good shot that landed. Very good overhand right. And I think Marty could be troubled by this. Looks like he hasn't got his balance and also the fatigue kicking in.
And you can see he's gassed out.
It looked like he was trying to showboat slightly there. I'm not too sure if I could be wrong. Marty using his head there, which he shouldn't be. It doesn't look like Marty wants to be there. This could be the closing of the fight from what I'm seeing here. It's telltale signs. The referee will be taking a close look at this as well. That's what he needs to do. Move around and get some, take some breaths, maybe clinch if he's tired. Staying there like that's not a good thing to do. Not against someone like Marty. He's very composed in his shots, shot selection, what he's doing. He's not allowing him to hold. I think that was a good body shot as well. All these shots are starting to take his toll. That was low, but that, I don't think that was any fault of his own. His head was down.
All Solomon need to do, he need to use his ring craft and keep his hands up whenever he know he's tired. But all the mistake he's doing is repeating the same mistake. Even I can see Hasib realize all the mistake he's doing. He's using the same hand, jab on the stomach, jab on the body, and over right hand. And it's all connecting and it's hurting.
Marty's just lost a point there. I think the coach wasn't happy and he was talking a lot. Again, if you keep seeing,
I didn't see what happened.
I'm not too sure, but it looks like the fight resumed anyway. But Marty was all over this round either way.
I didn't see where the mistake was. But we go to
good shot selection, man. He's, as you can see, look, he's throwing shots, he's out of range.
She just wanna dance and tease me. She just wanna
dance and tease me. She just
wanna dance and tease me.
We're going to the ninth round. It's a good fight so far. I thought it would end a bit earlier, but you know, Monty's showing courage, determination, heart. And no doubt he trained hard for this fight. Just how Amadi has as well. He's just executing his shots much more effective in this fight.
Good job from Hasib.
Go straight right there. He threw a hook and an uppercut, he nearly threw off balance. And this is what he doesn't need to be doing, especially in these later rounds where you're tired.
And he's doing the same mistake each over and over.
Good jab, dude. That was a stiff jab. from Amadi. It's good body work as well. These are effective and solid jabs to the body from Amadi. Good nice overhand right there. Again, Marty's losing the spring in his knees and his legs. He's coming up tall, so that means he's not generating any power at all.
He needs to bend on his knees so that he can control the fight.
And he needs to come out of the corner as well. He's getting caught with these shots, which he shouldn't really be getting caught with. Not to take anything from Marty, but these shots, he wouldn't be taking these if he's not backed up on the rope.
Yeah, that is exactly what Solomon needs to do. He doesn't need to stop or stand in front of Hasib.
I think that may have been why he was deducted a point.
Yeah. I think that's the same mistake that he did when he got point deduction.
Yes.
And referee seems to be so strict on the rules. Over here,
yeah.
You saw even he's trying to warn Solomon, coach. Oh,
good shot there, but it doesn't look like he's phasing Marty as much as it should. These are big, clean
punches
hits
coming from his way from his head.
I feel like if Marty were to throw that back and land it as Amadi is on him,
yeah,
and if he were to do that back, I think Amadi would be in trouble, but. Again, he just doesn't have the skill set to throw it and land it as clean as possible, as clean as he is. But it's a very good attempt. Very, very good attempt.
Good job from Hasib.
Good job from there.
And that's the end of the ninth round.
It's a good fight, all in all, but it looks like Amadi's really taking these rounds.
He controlled the fight from the first round till the ninth round.
Yep. In a convincing manner as well. It's not one time I thought it was the opposite way. I feel like Marty, he probably could have done better.
He
could have done much better in the rounds, but he's letting it slide. And I feel like this is down to discipline as well.
Do you think also some mistake coming from the corner men because they're supposed to be telling what?
Potentially. I'm not seeing any improvement or change
from
in the game.
That's right, that's what I'm saying. Because as your team, you're supposed to be telling you the mistake you're doing and what you're supposed to be calculating so that you can improve.
Exactly.
But again, he's been repeating the same mistake since we started the first fight for the first round.
It may be down to either lack of information from the corner or it could be the lack of
the boxer listening. Yeah.
To the corner.
Now here we go to the 10th round and the last round.
10th and final round. It's been a good fight so far. Been a very, very good fight.
Hasib controlling the fight from the first round.
In a very good way.
Yeah.
In a professional manner, he conducted himself well. Didn't, you know, smother his shots.
Head movement, ring craft.
Yeah.
Good punches. Yeah. See now, what Martin is doing now is what he was supposed to be doing all round.
Yes.
But now he's trying to realize that when it's too late. Good job from Martin now, moving his head. Oh, I think that place is kind of wet
there.
You're not supposed to be pouring a lot of water in the corner. It can cause trouble.
But also, Marty shouldn't be in the corner.
Yeah.
He's been in the corner for too many times in this fight.
Yeah.
And now he's moving, but again,
this is what he was supposed to be doing.
He should have been doing this from the earlier in the round, you know. And this is what his coaches probably should have told him.
Now he's realizing this mistake when it's too late.
Unfortunately, he's gonna learn the hard way.
He made Hasib look so comfortable.
But again, it's still 2 minutes of this fight, and he has the power to hurt him 100%. If
anything
I was in the corner, I'd have to say to be a bit more aggressive.
To fight. Yeah.
There's no point running or trying to bounce around the ring now and waste time when you know that you're down on the cards. Only way he could really win this is a knockout.
That's right.
So it's that time to really put it on him and, you know, keep throwing out them left hooks that he was trying.
He has good power. He has good stamina, but in discipline.
Good work there.
Good heavy shot from Hasib.
And he's even utilizing his forearm and his lead arm well as well, just holding him out, not getting him too close. Again, look, controlled by the lead arm, able to throw his shots, not able to get hit either. It's brilliant work.
Brilliant performance
again,
from Hasib.
This is the discipline that should be kicking in. You shouldn't be dropping your arms no matter what. His arms are dropping even when he's moving. He slipped, it could have been, you know, it could have gone different. Good combinations and shot selection from Omadi for sure.
We have 30 seconds to go to the last round. One more, he got it, like another 1 point.
I think this is a telling off this time. Shot to the body there.
Brilliant performance from Hasib.
Good overhand right there also. He's trying to land it right. The overhand right, it's good.
Last 10 rounds. And that was the end of the fight.
Good fight.
It was a good fight. I give it to Hasib. I'm not a judge, but still I give
the
it to Hasib.
Looks like there's a bit of conflict in the corner at the moment. The coaches and the referee. But the coaches need to remember that the referee can still disqualify him for this. Overall, it was a good fight. Omadi,
congratulations.
Should be victorious by right. It was good altogether. Good performance. But as a professional, you need to conduct yourself well, you know.
lui. Tu te fais du mal, s'il te plaît, n'y pense plus. Il a souillé ton âme, toi tu t'es battu. Ton cœur est plus précieux que de l'or. Ne pense plus à lui. Pour un homme, tu ne veux plus voir le jour. Des milliers d'entre eux rêvent de te faire l'amour. Ton corps est aussi beau que l'or. Que l'or.
Hazibul, I wanted to talk to you just for a minute here. Congratulations on your unanimous decision. 30 minutes up here. How do you feel?
Bismillah, walhamdulillah. First of all, thanks God for everything. And secondly, I would like to thank Mr. Ahmed Siddiqui, my sponsor Shanab and Kishmish, and Mrs. Wendy Doherty. She helped me a lot in this camp. I was really looking forward to fight the Cuban fighter for WBC Middle East, but unfortunately something happened and he couldn't fight. But alhamdulillah, they got me another opponent in the last minute. And thanks to my opponent, he took the fight last minute. And he did really well, like a real man. And alhamdulillah, for my victory, I feel very happy. Thank you so much.
Well, congratulations. One more question. How are you going to celebrate tonight?
Yeah, I will go with my family because in the camp, I was not at home 8 weeks. And I will be with my family and celebrate at home.
Excellent. Well, go enjoy it with them. Congratulations once again. One more round of applause for both of our fighters here tonight, ladies and gentlemen.
Pour un petit fils de Yen, je n'aurais jamais pensé qu'une femme comme toi puisse tomber aussi bas. Tu l'aimais, lui il t'a fait payer. Aujourd'hui tu le maudis, moi c'est toi que je maudis. Et tu vas comprendre pourquoi. Personne ne t'a forcé à rester.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, now the celebrations continue. We want to say thank you, everyone, once again for coming out here tonight for EMD Fight Night number 4. My name is Dylan Nikolatopoulos. We hope you enjoyed the evening. As you know, this is number 4, which means we got more coming. Stay tuned because the fight nights are only going to get better from here. One more thanks to all of our sponsors, Cuban Box Fight Club, People's Fighters, Voltrons, and Park Onyx. We're out of here, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. We'll see you next time here at EMD Fitness Dubai.
Fais du mal, s'il te plaît, n'y pense plus. Il a souillé ton âme, toi tu t'es battu. Ton cœur est plus précieux que de l'or. Ne pense plus à lui. Pour un homme, tu ne veux plus voir le jour. Des milliers d'entre eux rêvent de te faire l'amour. Ton corps est aussi beau que l'or. Que l'or.